Professor Herman Branover left the Soviet Union in 1972. He is a world-renowned scientist in the field of magnetohydrodynamics.
I had a remarkable advice of the Rebbe when I just came from Russia 20 years ago, and I didn't even start working in the free world in Israel. I didn't have even yet a laboratory. I had to build all that, and then I was by the Rebbe, and he asked me, what's my schedule for the next day? I told him I'm going to Philadelphia to give a lecture to students about the situation in Soviet Russia, about Soviet Jewry. And he immediately advised me, being in Philadelphia, please look up a professor in your field in magnetohydrodynamics of liquid of molten metals. I didn't respond, but in my heart, I was confused, because I knew, to the best of my knowledge, I followed developments in my field all over the world, and I believed, I know that in Philadelphia, there is nobody who works in my field. So next day when I came there, before I even could start thinking about going to my lecture for the students, I was taken by the local representative of Lubavitch there, because he asked me, what did the Rebbe told you? And I told him, the Rebbe told to find out where is the scientist who is working in my field. But I made a remark that it probably should be a mistake. The Chosid, the representative Lubavitch there, told me, there's no such a thing as mistakes. If the Rebbe told you, should go. And we started screening two universities in Philadelphia, Temple University and University of Pennsylvania, huge universities. We didn't know whom we were looking for. It's like in the old stories about Baal Shem Tov, when he instructed a Jew to go in some shtetl, in some small town, to find out a shoemaker, and great things ultimately came out of this. That's how we felt. And you can imagine two Jews are going from one building to another, asking, where is the professor who works in liquid metal magnetohydrodynamics? And everybody says, we never heard about, tell us the name, tell us his department. You know, we spent many hours during this day. I didn't eat, didn't drink the whole day. Ultimately, about 5 or 6 o'clock in the evening, it was during the winter, it got already dark, somebody told us, listen, I think that in the next building, that was already in Pennsylvania University, there should be somebody whose profession I think is magnetohydrodynamics. We went there. We found a person who was already locking his door, a professor of Chinese origin, and we asked him whether he works in magnetohydrodynamics. He told, yes, come in, please. And then I spent about an hour with him. He was very interested in my work in the Soviet Union. And what he did in the end, he invited me to give a talk on an annual meeting of people working in magnetohydrodynamics, which should be in about 6 weeks from that time in Palo Alto in California. I told him I cannot go, I have to return to Israel and at the end of my stay. And then he expressed his regret that I thought was the end of it. The next day I wrote a note to the Rebbe that I did find a professor. Why didn't I know he is in Philadelphia? Because it turned out that he just moved to Philadelphia from California, and I didn't know that. And the Rebbe wrote me back a notice, by all means, if only possible, change your ticket, stay 6 weeks, and go to the conference in California, which I did, of course. And then when I went there, I was immediately approached by two representatives of the American Navy, who told me, they learned that I'm participating in this conference, they came special to see me, and they offered me a contract. That's how my work in Israel started, because I would never have any sources to build a laboratory. Now it's the largest laboratory in this field in the world, in magnetohydrodynamics of liquid metal. And all that started from a very strange, from the first glance, not understandable instruction of the Rebbe.